I kind of drank the tea and sipped the tea. Here in November of 2014, in the St. Louis, it was our holy convocation that we have every year. I was new to the Church of God in Christ. I was new to church at the time. I've always been in church my whole life, but as grown, I was new to it. Only going to church just to shout and to see who I was going to sleep with pastor. But at that church, they delivered out of me. They were snatching that out of me. But now I get hard for women. I don't get hard for men. Ain't nothing wrong with a flirtation.
The hell you say? Yes, my dear viewers, I was the interviewer for this BET interview. It was during this time when I realized that the rare obese Lias scamicus was a species that required further research.
But I'm still delivering. The morning that I woke up, God told me to go to the store. I went and got me a bow tie, jacket, and all that. I just felt peace that day, like so much peace. And later that night, I was sitting down in the chair, and I was like, it's time for prayer. I went up there for prayer. I got the mic. He said, what do you want God to do? And I said, I'm delivered with the tea. I went home with the sleep, and I got back up, and I said, Lord, use me, because I want to be you.
You say you were still delivered, but if so, why did you harass this news station into doing this report on you?
Be appropriate for all people. You may remember him. He became a viral sensation, coining the phrase, I don't like men's no more. Well, Andrew Caldwell lives in Missouri, but for some reason, he reached out to us here at NBC 12 to clear the air about the video about his gay conversion. His experience is an incredible backlash. Chris Thomas investigates the dark side of going viral.
I'm not gay no more. I am delivered.
A conversation about sexuality that's generally had behind closed doors.
I don't like men no more!
Went viral at this Church of God in Christ conference in St. Louis. Songs were made.
I am delivered! I am delivered! I don't like men no more!
Cartoons were created.
I thought I like women! Women, 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 women!
All at the expense of Andrew Caldwell.
Was this some type of comedy routine, or were you serious?
I was serious, and I did not want to go viral. I did not expect that to go viral.
I did not want to get up there and just say anything, just look crazy in front of thousands of people.
Caldwell contacted me on my Facebook page after finding our original story online.
And y'all spoke about my video. I said, well, let me reach out to him then. Let him get the truth. Let him know what's really going on, you know, in the world. I went up there because I needed prayer that day. I needed so much prayer.
What did you come down here for? Tell me.
To get delivered more.
Yes, this scene came after Caldwell says he felt pressured by the speaker before him, who he says called gays in the church sissies and suggested they should bleed from their butts.
As presiding bishop of the Church of God in Christ, I apologize for what seemed to be a harsh, uncompassionate, disrespectful spirit on the part of that speaker. I also apologize to Andrew Caldwell. We love all people, regardless of their faith or their moral standard.
They think that they can preach their homosexuals away in the Church of God in Christ, and you can't.
I will love a woman.
Okay, so the bottom line here is, then this whole notion of you saying that you were delivered there on the spot, that is not the case, you're saying?
No, that's not the case.
Okay, and you still struggle with it from day to day?
Correct. It was just they trying to say, oh, he got delivered, yeah, he's delivered from home, so yeah, I might be, but I still have desires.
Do you have any regrets about what happened?
I do hold regrets on that because, you know, my life has been in danger.
In just the past week, Caldwell claims he was attacked and called homosexual slurs.
You know, that video caused a lot to me, mentally and physically. I feel that if I was delivered, God should deliver me more. But I know it'd take a process. But, you know, I think it's going a little bit slow.
How is it going?
Well, you know, I want God to work on my mannerism. I want God to stop the, you know, the switching, talking like a woman.
I would not tear a purse.
Despite all the laughing and name calling, Caldwell says he sincerely wants to be delivered and can't help feeling let down by this whole experience.
Continue to pray for me because I'm going through a lot each and every day.
So first and foremost, that reporter was shady as hell and I loved every minute of it. But most importantly, you told two different versions of this experience. So which is the truth?
One of my many utter lawyers just called me and said to say no comment.
I have been sitting in front of you the entire time, and you don't even have your phone. But, moving on.
Then that morning when I got up, people was knocking at my door to interview me. And they said, when your video went viral. I said, what video? I said, the church had me live and didn't tell me. I thought that screens in the church was only the people in the church and people watching it on the internet. Because at the time, it looked like I made a mock of God. I was not ready for this. I was not ready to be thrown in the spotlight. I wanted to kill myself. I had got me a glass, and I was sitting down that same day. I was crying, not because I went viral, because my emails, my phone calls, people was calling me. I don't know how they got my number. Was harassing. I heard a tiny voice saying, don't do it. And I started doing like this.
And I see you're still playing the victim with these death threats that you never showed any proof of. But please continue.
And do I ask for that? I would never ask somebody to go viral. The way I went viral, this is not something that no one wants. I wanted to kill myself several times.
It's several, goddammit.
My life has changed better and worse. The money, yes. I received money from Facebook. Like, my first big check was like $10,000. And I was like, yeah!
You claim to make so much money on Facebook, and yet we here at BET had to buy furniture for this empty apartment so that we could actually interview you. In fact, I'm not sure why you agreed to this interview, as you have said no comment to many of my questions.
The money was good. I have been granted to work with different organizations. I have been granted to, when I go fly Delta, I will have to pay the full price. Delta, thank you. Shade Room posted me with a woman. Let's make this clear. Yes, I have a girlfriend. Yes, I like meow. And don't be surprised when we have a wedding. Don't be surprised when we have a Caldwell walking around.
Now is my turn to say no comment. I'm trying my hardest not to go to hell. I will just say that Caldwellian children will look nothing like these pictures. Maybe more like Sloth from the Goonies. Brian, you just said you weren't going to do this.
And stop saying to my girlfriend on Facebook, in Shade Room, tell my girl, blink five times if you need help.
Okay, let's continue the interview outside. The must and breath fumes are starting to get to me.
See, people's looking me up and down. I had some love. And it's like, wow, these are churchy people that I'm supposed to love. I went viral. And now look what they did to me now. I really wish that I could just start fresh.
Okay, can we talk about the outfit? I'm sorry, off it. What the hell do you have on?
This is the place that I got hurt at. This is the place that I can't go back and just say, let's do it again. Let's start fresh.
Are the Special Olympics out here today?
My clothing line is coming out.